talking.
Yeah.
I'm not here.
Yeah, I know we're just talking about patents and subjects.
Yeah, they really do. They're very beautiful.
I
those colors really deep out.
Initially, I planned to paint faces, then I decided to continue drawing faces to the tree. That's why it became like continuation of the tree with leaves on top of them. And one is a woman tree and one is a man. They fall in love and do.
So do you know many people in the city?
I have some my three daughters in the city.
Oh, they do?
Yeah. So they will come.
And what do they do?
Well, my little daughter is working at Batman, staying in my husband. They asked him to come over to create a small video for YouTube.
So you put it up on YouTube?
Yes.
Well, maybe on my website.
Okay,
it actually you can embed it to the exhibit on the slideshow.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what they do. To ask their
family. Yeah.
And their family. To be,
you look at me in where I'm
at.
At one point in the past, we had together a program. You can more explain about it.
Well, I did a series of performance pieces based on
the music. Oh, okay.
So,
a
joint show.
Yeah.
So, where did
you
bring
your
dancer? One of the things,
yeah.
She's perfect. What was she made besides the form?
Yeah. A couple in Europe. But the work is more, it's movement and theater. Sometimes I would look at one of his paintings and whatever inspired me. So sometimes it would be more of a story and sometimes more of a dance.
You based out on the
performance here?
Well, we looked at the space and said it's just a little too tight. Just a little too tight. Yeah, not quite the same.
Maybe in a different environment. We performed in a couple of places in Albany, Woodstock.
Yeah, well, I know Woodstock very well. I have a lot of friends here. And I know some of the galleries there.
Yeah. And look. You can pass by it to a...
Oh, it's okay. I really see it. It's good.
Yes, I did. I did a talk show for a while here in New York City. And I did a feature for the longevity report for several years on WEBD, so the station was so very popular. Until it was sold to ESPN, Sports Now.
Yeah. You interviewed a guy who brought Beatles to the United States. Brought first time in 1964 Beatles.
Yes, Sid Bernstein.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, and, yeah, I did a piece about that because a lot of people, attribute that to Ed Sullivan.
Right.
And it's not true. It's not true. In fact, I met with, he died, Sid Bernstein, but his son is promoting that. In fact, several years before he died, he was trying to get the rights to Woodstock to be more than the Woodstock. And never quite worked out. But he was the one who was the one who was was here. And because he brought him here, and they were coming, when he signed him up to
struggle for life, the pain what they had in the alive, and only what could help them and what they hope for is that way they play us. And I remember when I was in Miami, one person told me that when her mom was in concentration camp in Auschwitz, her mom was about 14 years old, and she always was in pain of life that she had, and from the officer would beat her on her head, and appreciate her pain more than she had already in Auschwitz. And her mom told her that, which also was enough at that time, the only prayer would wait for her to get out, because nothing else could help her except her belief. And she would always, her mom point to the tree and to the leaves on the tree, and said, you have to pray and hope, and put the hope. And that's what she did. And her father also was in concentration camp, but was in a different camp. And they prayed as much as until they had been liberated eventually from the Soviet army. And prayer in some way served them in being helpful. That is in having memory of people who perished in the Holocaust and had only prayers in their breath in order to survive.
That's the background of the old
wives? Mm-hmm. Yes, that is like the settle in background architecture in Israel, which is many survivors went to Israel and to Jerusalem, and place where only could protect them, and they swear never again, and that should be repeated in their life. And that's why I intentionally paint architecture not in East Europe, I painted architecture of Israel or Middle East, where they moved after World War II, after back to Israel, many of them.
Just very happy. I told her I'm all businesses in the place for a while, you know, to explore new ideas. She's doing her act of show, it takes her right here, you know. But I said,
it's the same for family.
And I love the works. In fact, if you wish, I would like to put one of them up on the show. Sorry.
Yeah, if you do.
Okay, very well. I'll get in touch with you.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, thank you for coming. Thank you.
Here, there is my sister Sarah, my nephew, my friend David.
Thank you.
continuation of beauty and each of them different types of butterflies.
All the different flowers have different
hooks of butterflies? Yeah, but I try to do the different types of butterflies, different roses, in order to make some different bodies. And also, it was in memory of our brother Leighton, who died in. I don't know if you knew. And the LA.
Woman
which represents places.
Dagestan.
Like,
I know everything.
Yeah. And I decided to paint, to dedicate many of the things I do. And that's the prayer that feel like. Mali was in the transportation time, and this whole the population went out of the and Nazi, particularly, I actually didn't know why it was very rough to go to Israel and to Mali.
It's just I don't need a lady. we're here. We walked down from Times Square.
Oh, you walked?
Yeah.
You probably got wet.
We did.
How far were you?
Am I taking bets from anyone?
No.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure. And then,